Charlie, how are you doing?
Good, my G. How are you?
Yeah. Much better than I was the last time we've been speaking, you know. How were you feeling at the time?
I was feeling like I was about to have malaria. So I just got scared. And, you know, and you and I went out on the Wednesday and I called you and you were feeling funny as well. So I just started to assume the worst. And I'm like, you know what? I'm out of here. I just went out to the country to just self-isolate. I've been here by the lakes and just taking my vitamins and listening to music and dancing and getting 100% back, you know.
I, on the other hand, got really sick on Friday, and I was feeling hot and fevery.
Wow.
And my bones were aching, my eyes were aching, my temperature going up and down to 40 degrees, and then I was shivering because you sweat so much. And it actually, you're right, it did feel like I had malaria. So as you're stuck in the UK, what are you doing in lockdown?
You know, just cooking, sleeping, drinking as much food as possible, and just trying to, you know, stay positive. You know,
what has helped you get through these times?
You know, talking to my mom a lot. You know, you know, African moms. Like, I mistakenly told her I was feeling funny, and then she's been flooding me with broadcast messages.
Oh,
go do this one. Go do this one. Go bite this one.
Your mom and my mom alike.
Yeah, I've been like, mom, okay, I'm fine. That's one thing I think has happened in this season. You know, I've stayed more in touch with family.
Yeah, amazing, man. Have you been in touch with other musicians and seen how they're dealing, and other industry people, what they're saying, what they're doing?
To be honest, just Joe Boy. And Joe Boy has just been in he just bought himself equipment and been in his studio recording. He just keeps sending me like a song a day.
Oh, wow.
DJ Neptune and his producer sent me like 2 beat packs. And I was speaking to Peruzzi from Nigeria as well yesterday. We were just doing a digital play session. He'll play some of his new music. I'll play some of my new music up until 4 a.m. And it was kind of cool.
We should have done that with our session then.
I'll tell you.
And what impact has the virus had on your plans?
For the time I've just been in the UK, you know, so all travel plans have obviously been cancelled, which is the right thing. I have a couple shows cancelled, couple meetings. Like, you obviously can't do anything, but you know, we thank God, we're grateful. You know, in the midst of all this, there's been some good news here and there with, you know, people getting better. I've been seeing a lot more dance videos for my songs, people using the songs and the music and all the dances to whilst they're in quarantine. There's this one that went viral of a mom, her son, and her husband. Is hit over 8 million views on my Twitter. I've never had anything go that viral on my Twitter before. So I'm like, wow. So in this time, you know, it's beautiful that the music can still bring so much happiness. And the reaction from people around the world, seeing the family just indoors and dancing to my music, is just, I just think that's been a miracle in this whole time.
Okay, amazing, man. So Mr. Eazi, keep getting well. Do you have any message for the fans?
Please stay at home. The virus is real. There's really nothing more we can do than our own part. You know, my heart goes out to, you know, all the doctors who are like at the first line of defense, the medical workers, the doctors, the nurses, you know, who are, you know, sacrificing and putting themselves at risk every day. Is warm wishes to all of them, and to my fans is, yo, stay indoors, wash your hands, and, you know, stay far away from the older people, you know, care for them, but at length, because you might not know you have the virus and you don't want to get other people sick.
Yeah, so I appreciate you, and thank you, obviously, man.